So some want to say this could be the debate of checking the heart and checking the notes. What is the source of where the neshama resides? Does the neshama reside in the heart circulatory system? Or does the neshama reside in the brain cavity, in the moach? But obviously those who say it resides in the heart cavity says you have to check the heart. If the heart's no longer beating, that indicates that the circulatory system is shut down. If that's shut down, that should be an indicator that this physiological phenomenon indicated there was the metaphysical concept of Yetzias and Shabbat taking place, what we call in English cardiac death. And therefore, I don't have to check any further because that's the crucial determination of life and death. It just so happens, in reality, that without a respirator, that once your heart shuts down, automatically it shuts down your lungs biologically because you can't have the lungs functioning without a functional heart. And vice versa is also true. If your lungs shut down without a respirator, if your lungs shut down, your heart shuts down. So over here the question is, which is the crucial point? Which is the cart and which is the horse? If you say cardiac death is the crucial part, you check the cardiac function, it's no longer functional, cardiac death took place, and that's it. Those who say I have to check the neshima, they're saying I have to check the nose. Why? Because the nose is a source of respiration, and since respiration is controlled, as I mentioned before, by the vagus nerve contained in the medulla of the brain, if you're no longer having any respiration, that indicates that you've undergone brain death, and therefore brain death is an indication, but obviously, of respiratory death, even though in actuality, the two different camps when it comes to this technicality. If you want me to go into that later on, I will if you have a question about that. But idea being is the Gemara therefore is positing two possibilities. Either cardiac death versus respiratory brain death, which is the indicator of death. Where is the neshama residing over here? There are some afashim in the Ein Yaakov, in fact, who learned the debate, being exactly this old philosophical machlokas going back to the time of the Zohar and the Rishonim and the Achronim had the debate, where does the soul reside? Where is the Mishkan HaNeshama? So therefore, that's their debate. When the Gemara later on says that if you find the person knows first, Rav Papa, we declare a person dead. So those who want to press the agenda of the concept of respiratory brain death says, they went out. By the fact you have to check the nose, that means that once you check the nose, and you know there's no longer respiration, that indicates stop a respiration, stop a brain activity. And therefore, that's how Yeshiva Shama is recognized based upon this biological fact. So therefore, those who wanted to push the agenda in their shita of what we call respiratory brain death, learn the Gemara literally, this is what the Gemara is teaching us, and that was the debate going on behind the scenes. Now, when you learn a Blat Gemara, we've learned when we went to Cheder, you got to learn with the Shtikla Rashi over here, Rashi and Tosfos. So when you look in Rashi on this, and it was alluded to before, Rashi paints a little different picture, and this is where the whole major controversy comes into existence. Look at the way Rashi learns the Gemara. This on your pages is quotation G, H and I over here. Once again, I'll read the Hebrew, but I'll translate it into perfect English. Nobody will have any problem of understanding what I'm saying to you over here. Rashi says over here, when the Gemara tells us, you came on location and you found a person motionless, you see the person is inanimate, there's no movement of the physical parts of his body that are at least visible. How far do I have to go to know whether, in fact, the person expired or didn't expire? What are the physical, biological concepts which indicate that a metaphysical concept of death took place? Listen to what Rashi says. Rashi continues over here. So Rashi says, "At chotmo, I checked the nose. If there's no life indicative by the nose," how did they check the nose? They used to take a little feather and put it by the nose. If they saw it moving, it means air was coming out, or a little very thin piece of paper. That's called the air test. If you see there's chias, the halach is he's still alive. In ein chias, if there's no air coming out, even faint amount the air, shein emotzi ruach vademes, he's dead, and you can't do any chil shabbos to take his body out as a Jew. Now, the Gemara then says, Rashi says, holy God, omer apapa. There is an assumption amongst many achronim that Rashi could have had a different gears in the Gemara, where Papa came immediately after the Bryce above. Not that you had the other information between of where a person is developed, where it comes from the middle for the head, which I'm not going to get into now, is a separate Bryce that was brought in later on. From Rashi, it seems to imply that the whole debate, whether you check the heart, whether you check the nose, was followed immediately by Papa's interpretation of that. Machlokes milmala milmata lamala. Now this, every word is gold over here. Machlokes, the controversy is Tahani Tanoi the Ma'ama ad libo, uma'ama ad chotmo. If you notice, Rashi's guess was the heart was first and the nose afterwards. What's the debate? If you found the person foot first, Melamata Lamala, Shemota Defa Nagalo, so if you find the feet sticking out, Bodek Vahola, if you therefore start to excavate the stones upon the body, and you move towards the head, Vahola Kalapi Rosha. The Ma'ama Baliba, one says when you come to the cardiac activity, the cardiac area of the body, the middle of the body, Yesh Lahafin, you can try to figure out and see and perceive. In Yesh Balchias, if there's still life, Shenishmaso Dafek Ishan. These are three extra words in Rashi that the Balei Kabbalah take tremendous chashivas with. The Chacham Tzvi unquestionably looked upon this as a sign that Rashi was one of those who held the neshama resides in the heart and the circulatory system. Shenishmaso Dafek Ishan. And therefore, you're going to see if the heart's still pumping. If the heart's still pumping, the soul is contained in the heart and the circulatory system is still intact, and the metaphysical process of death has not taken place. So what's the opinion? You have to check to the nose. The zimnin and hias nika belibo, the nika bechotmo. The reason you check the nose is not because you're rejecting cardiac death, because nishamasa dafekiswa. Rashi already told you which camp he's in. He's in the camp of cardiac death. His concern is there's a possibility I might not be able, without a stethoscope, there's no stethoscope on Rabbi's side, I might not be able, with a trauma victim who might be a little heavy, and therefore, under a trauma situation, under a building, you will not be able to feel any type of beating of the heart touching the ribcage. And therefore, you can't tell whether there's cardiac or not, and you can't listen. There's no way of listening or knowing. So therefore, to make sure, in fact, the person's dead, let's go a little higher. Go up to the nose. Why? Because if there's no air coming out of the nose, it means they stopped respiration. And if there's no respiration, there surely ain't any cardiac activity taking place. The checking, therefore, of the respiration is looked upon as a chumrah to verify, in fact, cardiac death took place. Now, how do I know that's the way Rashi learned? I didn't dream this up. We go to the next page, and that is page number 2. One of the great gedolim we have in Jewish history, a very famous personality, as was mentioned before, was the Chacham Tzvi. Everybody here, Rav Yaakov Emden, this was the father of Rav Yaakov Emden, so you understand the stature who we're dealing with over here. And this Chacham Tzvi, a tremendous Talmud Chacham, Mekubal, Pesek, has a Shel Tzuvis of the Chacham Tzvi. And he writes a little perish on this Gemara, and it's his perish that later on was used by many poskim in understanding Rashi and understanding what the Mahalak, the interpretation of this Gemara is. Let me just show you something. It starts over here right on top, these two paragraphs. I'm not going to do every word in the paragraph, I'm going to skip around, but I want to show you certain salient points in the Chacham Tzvi that show us which camp he basically subscribes to. The Chacham Tzvi says the following. He brings Harav Eloki, Rav Yitzhak Luria, one of the great Kabbalists, Asheruach Elokim Dibabo, the God Spirit spoke in him, Iskin, agreed Lamashim Lefursim, he agreed to what is known, L'chol Ansh Olam, to all people of the world, Shalei Ku Mishkin Lenefesh Chinus, the heart is the source of the live nefesh, the soul is in the heart, Hu Ameis Achrona, is the last organ to die, Acharei Misas Kolavarim, after the death of all the other organs, Harachot and Karavim Ula, those who are far or distant from it, are those who are near to it, Upirish Bezed Divrei Nevi Beis Kel, the Kamachakos B'Shma Adon Agad L'Maharit, the Maharit, who was one of the great Gedolei Poskim of Italy, agreed with this concept as well, Sharsha B'Zohar, the Zohar, if you look in the Zohar, you'll find the concept, the heart being the essence of life of a human being's body, is being the essence of the Hashkafa of the Zohar, which means at this point in time, what the Chacham Tzvi has done is identified himself as a cardiac death Jew interpreter.